first of all, the council meetings were on the net, so they were open. And people could watch. They could also come physically and watch, but you could sit at home and watch them on your screen. Secondly, you could send in comments. They received 3,600 some comments from the public, and they received more than 360 formal suggestions for paragraphs in the constitution, and these would then be debated. They would not necessarily be adopted or accepted, but they would be debated. Okay. And that could be followed. If you followed the discussion, you could see whether your suggestion was being respected or not. Okay. So I think that was a very important part. The people of Iceland, they are stakeholders in this process. They feel they are stakeholders. And in the parliament, we have the opposition has set itself against the process. I think just out of old habit of being against everything that the ruling parties suggest. There was a national referendum on the 20th of October where the bill was being put to a referendum asking the people, do you want us to continue? Or what? And 66, if I remember correctly, percent of the voters said yes, we want you to continue. So there is a two-third majority of those who took part in the election who actually voted for. So I think they have backed themselves up with this bill, but it still remains to be seen what, say we have election now coming next spring, 2013, and it's hard to tell what the new parliament will do. I think that is something that you have to just watch happening, you know. The constitution is of course the fundamental law on which everything else has to be built. So everyone has access to it, and now something which wasn't previously, the Icelandic population is very well aware of the constitution. They weren't very well aware of it before. So now, I mean, leading up to the referendum in October, every household got a brochure with the current constitution and the new constitution and comparing the paragraphs. Mm. So they have the constitution, they have access to it, and then they can simply follow. I think that is the way it will be done. And of course there will be some action groups and those who are vigilant who will point out to people if the law which is being set somehow doesn't seem to be in accordance with the constitution. But that again is something which the parliament should never do. I mean, they must take care that the law abides by the constitution.